No, Mr. Alfie Bowie, but you are channeling, and I knew he was in there, like your rock god.
A little bit, I am. Yeah, my new album, I've sort of had this idea, this concept for 20 years, I'd say. And it was really a collaboration of rock music and showing the public that the beauty of rock music and the structure of that music and collaborating it with the classical world that I came from and showing how the two worlds can blend and how it works perfectly together.
Nice.
With my voice.
Yeah.
Alfie, you've been through some tough times recently, which you've been very open about. And you talk about them in your latest autobiography, don't you? Called Face the Music.
Yeah.
What's the significance of the title?
Well, I mean, Face the Music is a connection, obviously, with the job that I do. You know, I face music every time I step up on stage each night and put across emotions. But Face the Music is a phrase that we've probably all used at some point, where we have to connect with things that concern us, things that worry us, things that are bringing us down, struggles in life, trauma in life, the ups and downs, you know. So, and if you don't face them and you just brush them under the carpet, then they're just going to fester. So that was really my intention of using this platform as the book to explain to people that how I dealt with all that, you know, what got me through those tough times.
You shouldn't underestimate yourself, which it does help people as well. We've had Kennedy, who's wrote in, and he said, so what do you do when the depression hits you? Some days I'm still trying to figure out how to deal with it.
Whenever I'm feeling sad or feeling low, I connect with it. You know, I embrace it. I don't try and be something that I'm not feeling. You know, I don't try and think, okay, I'm feeling a bit low, but I'm going to put on some happy music and dance around the room or whatever and try and get myself out of this mood. If you do that, you're not addressing it. You're not dealing with it. Again, you're brushing it under the carpet.
Yeah.
So whenever I am feeling low, I do play some sad music and I do sit on my own and contemplate and think about the past and think about what it is that's getting me down, because then it's out in the open.
Yeah.
I can deal with it and I can put it aside.
Okay,
and
when you take Minnie out, is she on your right or your left?
Left.
But you talk also in the book about
Left. Your
parents. The book is dedicated to your lovely man.
Yeah. Yes.
And you talk about how your dad really inspired your love of music, didn't he? And cars.
He did, yes, and for cars as well. He was a big fan of the of vintage cars. He used to buy one and then do it up in the driveway. But his love for music was incredible. It was my first education. You know, his collection of songs in the house was from country music, Jim Reeves, Don Williams. We had classical opera singers. We had the Glenn Miller Orchestra. It was this eclectic mix of music that just filled the house constantly. And that was why I feel that there's no boundaries between. Exactly. Yeah. And it's why there's no boundaries between genres for me.
Yeah.
So I can do this rock album and collaborate with an orchestra.
Yeah.
Alfie, talk to us now about the Talk of the Coast. Which was the Viking Hotel?
It was, yes.
It is. What does this kind of place mean to you?
That was really the first place that I stood up on stage as a solo cabaret artist. I played there I took part in a singing competition. It was like a weekly thing where you'd go through all the rounds and I didn't win.
What did they know?
My jacket didn't have enough sequins on it.
it was a
fun thing to do every week, and I focused on my performance, and it was like an apprenticeship.
Yeah.
And I got to meet lots of great big name comedians. Bradley Walsh used to come down quite a lot, and
well, we got in touch with them.
And did you?
Yeah, and the barman Paul remembers you.
No.
And he sent this message.
Are you serious? Alfie Bob performed at the Viking Tour of the Coast many years ago. Yeah, he's done very, very well for himself. And hopefully we'll see him again in the future, and we hope he can perform again at the Viking.
Oh my goodness, that's
that's
crazy.
Brilliant. Well, Alfie's book, Face the Music, is out tomorrow, and his album, Open Arms, the Symphonic Songbook, is available for pre-order from today.
Thank you.
Right, on to you, Jamie. You've been busy, haven't you?